Legendary martial arts master Bruce Lee is a pop culture icon, introducing martial arts to the masses. But what was he like away from the limelight? Well, we had a chance to catch up with one of his original students. 70-year-old Jerry Petit is a Jeet Kune Do master. His teacher was none other than Bruce Lee. So right off the bat, I asked, what was Bruce Lee really like?
He was a little kid. He liked to giggle. He was a practical joker. He pulled a few good ones on me.
Like what?
I was in his library one day, and I was looking, and on the library there's a big sign, do not touch. So I'm bending over, and I'm looking at all the books, and I've got my hands behind my back because I'm impulsive. You know, I reach out and I'll do these things, so I'm trying to stay within the, you know, I don't want to get caught touching anything. Anyway, Bruce entered the room at the far end there, and he said, Jerry! And I turned, just as I turned, there's this three-sectional staff, and that's three pieces of wood with chain that connects them all together. And it's already right here in my face by the time I turned. He timed it. So as I turned, it hit me right in the face. Boom! And I hit the ground. I'm waiting for the pain, and it was made out of foam rubber. And so, yeah, he was laughing all the way out the door. I said, all right, you had your fun. Now let me have it. He says, yes, you can look at my books, but don't lose the place. I said, don't put them back where you found them.
What kind of books did he have?
Everything on the martial arts, everything, everything on philosophy.
Bruce set Jerry up with his own training schedule. How were his classes really? Was it very expensive to be a student? Or?
No, not really. A lot of times, like if you couldn't pay, which I was a couple of times with me and I was out of work, he'd say, forget about that. Your own attitude that counts, you know, it's your training that counts. Come anyway, it doesn't matter.
And how did he hold his classes? Was he very strict in class?
Yes, very. He laughed and giggled, but when it came to training, he was a taskmaster.
Was he a workaholic?
Bruce worked, you know, with himself, I guess he was tireless. He would go on forever, you know, and about the only time that if we were sitting down eating someplace and we were talking was always about philosophy.
Jerry is known as one of the biggest Jeet Kune Do teachers in the world. I asked his wife, Fran, what can she tell me about her husband?
He wants every single student to be the best that they can be. He doesn't want to show off. He doesn't want to show what he knows. He wants you to be the best you can be. And he encourages you, and it's in a very positive way, and that's how he is in his life. He used Jeet Kune Do to survive the fight of his life when he had a liver transplant in 1995.
Unbelievable. He looks healthy like a horse.
Yes,
right?
He does. I was told to make funeral arrangements that he wouldn't survive. And there's living proof of the living philosophy of Jeet Kune Do.
Amazing. Yes. 12 years ago they thought that's it, and because of the power of Jeet Kune Do.
Yes.
Longest weapon to the nearest target.
Longest weapon to the nearest target. Longest weapon is the leg, nearest target is the shin. Joe Leblow is an instructor under Jerry. I asked him, what are the principles of Jeet Kune Do?
Which is the four principles. Economy, simplicity, longest weapon, the nearest target, and always think hit.
Jeet Kune Do is a specialized, I would say Jeet Kune Do is a fine art. If we would use the other arts as an example. Taekwondo has a very, it's a great art. I have a black belt in Taekwondo. That was one of my first arts. But it's more of a sport art. And Jeet Kune Do is a fine art. Jeet Kune Do is Harvard.
What do you think about Jerry?
First time I met him, I was very intimidated because I knew who he was for a long time. Just never thought I'd meet him. And when I did, I was really surprised to see how gentle he was.
To learn more about Jerry, check out his website, jerrypetit.com. In Los Angeles, I'm Ellie Sekbeck.